Welcome back to our Proactive London studio, where I'm talking to Steve Brown now. He's the CEO of Accesso, and it's great to see you, Steve. How are you?
I'm great, thank you. Good afternoon.
Very pleasant to see you. The last couple of times we've spoken, it's all been about acquisitions that you made during the first half of this year. And now we're going to be talking about your interims, obviously, which pertain to the 6 months to the end of June. So perhaps you could tell us a bit about those acquisitions and about the other highlights as you see them.
We had a very busy first half of the year, as you say. Acquisitions were top priority for us going into the year. We had accumulated a very nice cash balance and did quite a bit of work thinking about what's the best way to spend that and invest that in our future. And we made three key acquisitions across the period. One, BGS, which was based in Milan, arguably the most powerful ticketing and entitlement system available in the marketplace. We acquired a ski provider called Paradocs that's based in Canada, really adding to our portfolio of ski customers and ski technology. And then we did a tuck-in with a partner we've been working with for quite some time based in Cork. Been using them as an augmentation group for our mobile app development and brought them in-house to Accesso and expanded our bench strength. And so really happy to have made the three acquisitions that we set out to do in the beginning of the year and bringing those into the fold in the first half of the year, alongside delivering very solid results for the period. So our team has been extremely busy.
It certainly sounds like it. We'll look at the financial performance of the business in a moment, but just looking at those acquisitions, how are they bedding in, do you think, so far?
Well, so far, so good. You know, we've done these a few times over the years. We've gotten quite proficient at how we incorporate an acquisition into our business. And I have to say they're going extremely well. Really high caliber team members in all three of these companies. We added about 90 team members to our group as part of those acquisitions in Canada, in Milan, in Ireland, all around the world. So it's really been a great time bringing those into the fold, getting to know them a bit more, and starting to leverage all the different resources we have available as they think about their business and as we think about making them more part of ours.
Understood. So let's look at the financials now. Still a lot of growth, but the margin under pressure, Steve.
Certainly. You know, we expected this. This is no surprise. As we went into this year, we were investing in a new product called Accesso Freedom, which is a retail and restaurant platform, an asset we purchased in 2022. We're working to complete one of the products that was underway there. So that's adding some additional staffing costs, as well as we have the wraparound of better hiring conditions compared to last year. You know, the market was very competitive in 2022. We've been able to fill our open positions against, positions and work we need to get done. So we're very happy to have those roles, now fully in place. And so we expected that to happen. And we are heavily weighted in the second half of the year. We're now near the end of September. We have sight into July, into August, and most of September. Things are very much on track for our full year expectations. And so it's more about the full year than, I think, overthinking the first half of the year in terms of the numbers. You know, we're looking at it holistically across the whole year, and we're really happy with where we are, especially as you think about, quality results alongside the fundamental kind of transformational moves we've made with these acquisitions.
And perhaps worth mentioning as well that I think the first half was slightly affected by some adverse weather conditions that did cause some loss as well.
You know, some of our customers had some adverse weather. You know, when was the last time you heard of flooding in Los Angeles, right? So there were some unusual weather events that were going on in different areas, especially in that sort of February, March period. And also customers, I think, were realizing that, the demand in 2023, there may have been some pent-up demand in 2022 that was now kind of burning off, and they needed to make some adjustments to their pricing and their product strategies. And they made those as any business operator would do. And we started to see those volumes really start picking up as we got into June, July, and into August. So, the first half of the year, is part of our business, but we really look at the overall, the overall year in total, and we're really happy with where we are.
And let's round things off today, Steve, by looking even further forward into the future. Tell us a bit about your vision for the next few years.
Well, I said, $200 million and a 20%+ margin by 2025. And I can tell you, I'm very focused on delivering against that. These acquisitions are an essential part of that growth strategy. Geographically expanding to new territories like the Middle East and in Asia. We now have the pyramids of Egypt and the Colosseum in Italy as customers. I mean, we're really focused on our growth strategy and improving that margin as time goes forward. And I just think that the moves we've made this year have paved a whole new path for us in terms of new opportunity and growth. And I could not be happier with where we are this year. And just looking forward to the full year 2023 and sharing those results in totality when we get there.
We look forward to having you back then, if not before, Steve. All the very best, and we'll catch you again soon, I'm sure.
Always a pleasure. Thank you.